I think what's important that's been mentioned there is the fact that a lot of restructuring took place within Grinrod, and I just want to understand the levels at which this really had a positive impact on these numbers.
There's been a lot of restructuring already, but there's more to come, and that's what we've announced today. The biggest change is the listing of our shipping business on the NASDAQ. It's a business that has for many years been based in Singapore, so it remains there. It'll be listed on the NASDAQ. It'll be inward listed onto the Johannesburg Stock Exchange. But it'll effectively be a separate business. And we think that that's important. It's important to create focus, to be able to have or to let shareholders compare us as a shipping business with the best in the world. And we think the best location for that will be the NASDAQ. So, yeah, we're excited about it. Been other changes as well.
Sure, Mike, what I was actually going to ask is right up that alley of NASDAQ, because we've seen Saudi Aramco struggle between, well, making a choice whether to go with London or to go with NASDAQ or to go with the the New York Stock Exchange. How did you arrive at NASDAQ per se?
You know, our business, as I mentioned earlier, is based in Singapore. So obviously that was the first port of call. The second one was the Johannesburg Stock Exchange, because that's where Grinrod Limited is listed. So we compared the JSE with Singapore, with Hong Kong, with London, with Oslo. It was clear to us that New York or NASDAQ were the two exchanges where there were the most shipping companies. There was the most shipping interest. It's a very specialized business. As you all know, it was involved the Greeks many, many years ago, but it's a very specialized, very, not difficult, but it's you've got to know what you're doing. And we thought that it would be best to be on the NASDAQ, so we're excited about that. We think it's a wonderful change for the group. You know, one of our ships today would cost anything from $28 million to $30 million. That's one vessel. And I think that's the size of the issue one's talking about. You're not talking about buying motor cars. You're not talking about cornflakes. You're talking about a serious asset.
Yeah. I mean, and the idea that you're going to be, you said earlier that it's going to be handled as a separate business. Talking about the industry at large, are you confident in the growth of the industry, particularly in shipping, and the opportunities that this will present to all stakeholders involved?
Rupiwa, we think so. There were years going back to 2007, 2008, where the shipping rates were through the roof. They were unrealistic, and the Grinrod business made a huge amount of money in those days. They dropped down to the lowest ever in 2016, and they're now running at between 3 and 4 times higher in the 2 years from beginning of 2016, and we see the trend moving upwards. So we're comfortable that the timing is right. We believe the timing is right. So yeah, that's where we are.
Right, Mike, I have to ask you about the headline loss. We're looking at close to 203 million rand. This is for 2017. Would one argue that maybe this wasn't the right time to actually go listing?
We think it's the right time because the market is moving strongly. And in fact, it's been suggested to us that we may be even a bit behind the market. So there's always that debate. When is the right time? You don't want to be too early. You don't want to be too late. We started this process 7-8 months ago. It's been a very detailed process. You can imagine on the NASDAQ and inward into Johannesburg, where you're talking about US dollars in terms of one currency being used for the NASDAQ. You're talking about rands and the other. You're talking about US GAAP, as they call it, versus IFRS. Everything is a little different. So it's taken a long time, but we think the timing is right.
And then just moving back to the restructuring that we briefly spoke about a little bit earlier, and that you said there was more to come. Surely this is capital intensive, and I think just to paint a picture for your stakeholders, what kind of restructuring or opportunities are you going to be exploring, and really the funding for this, where will that be coming from?
Okay, I think your question is broad, and let me start by saying that some of the restructuring we've been doing is exiting those businesses that we believed we shouldn't be on into the, shouldn't be in into the future. And that was rail locomotive manufacture, assembly, rail construction, which was laying railway lines in Africa. And those were very specialized businesses. So we believed that we shouldn't be part of that. We've exited that over the last 6 months, and that has helped the process. So yeah, will there be other restructuring? There are wonderful opportunities out there. South Africa is, as a country, looking a lot more positive than it did before. So whether it be the shipping environment, we see opportunities in that. In terms of the freight and logistics environment, we see opportunities there as well. So yes, there will be change, there will be further change into the future, but we see very positive change. We believe, we hope we're right, that we are now effectively out of those businesses that we shouldn't have got into, if I can use that term.